Well, we're back with artist Bobby Mastrangelo and her great artwork that's on display here at the Prism Gallery in Port Jefferson. Now, this one I recognize, Bobby, from your T-shirt.
Right. When I moved to Port Jefferson, it was one of the few manhole cover artworks that I brought with me, and we made postcards that were selling locally in town, visit our historic town. We also made T-shirts when we painted the manhole covers down the street as a whole team.
Now, was this piece from a real Port Jefferson manhole cover?
Yes, it actually was. It was down behind the village in the parking area, and the 197 was marked out on the road. The individual sewers are marked out so that they have an idea of their location.
Now, this looks like it could be real, like that's rusted metal there, but how do you make it to look so real?
I paint the foam, the finished foam, adding sand and texture on it, and paint it to look like the color of metal with acrylics.
So this is made out of foam, all these little bumps?
Canvas with there's sand on it and acrylic paint. Later on, I started not using canvas because it can't hold all this weight, and I've used foam right on wood.
So what inspired you to do this piece or the Port Jefferson piece?
All of these three pieces right here. Well, you know that I like to do manhole cover work. That's basically my theme. And there are a lot of calls for painting, so I decided to use a rubbing type of effect where I hand rip out paper just like it would be a rubbing relief and paste it onto a surface that already has spackled on it, and you have a new interesting texture, low relief.
With blocks of foam, cement, and acrylic paint, Bobby Mastrangelo creates her manhole cover art, and she actually goes onto the road site to take rubbing. So is this a rubbing from a local road site?
Yes, it's a Port Jefferson manhole cover right up here on Tuthill Street. And as you notice, the Port Jefferson part of it is covered up with asphalt, so I had to kind of figure out how the letters would be.
So this is the first step in creating one of these big masterpieces.
Yes, I keep a reservoir of manhole cover photographs and the rubbings. So I have that right from the street, and then I can transfer it onto my artwork using carbon to trace it.
So briefly walk us through the process. You're some crazy lady sitting in the middle of the street rubbing?
Only once in a while. Often a manhole cover will be on a sidewalk, and those are the ones I prefer to document.
We're glad to hear that.
Both in photos and rubbings. Okay,
rub it, and then you transfer it to foam and start carving at the foam?
Right. I use the carbon paper underneath and draw it on, and then I remove this and cut out all the letters, add cement on the texture, using foam.
I heard people accuse you of using real manhole covers in your pieces.
Well, they're so convincingly real that that's what they say. They think that I just took them, stole them, and put them in the work on the wall.
And how long could it take to do a piece like this?
This one, it could take months, and I worked on it under pressure to get it done just to fit in this wall in this particular gallery.
And this really looks like a true road.
Right, it's called Tuthill Street.
Well, most people drive or walk right over them, but not Bobby Mastrangelo. These are her works of art, and these are her manhole covers. Now, we saw your sculptures earlier, but this is something else. These are prints.
Right, these are prints on handmade paper. I make my own paper, and I have a block right here that I can show in a minute that I use. I carve out the shape, for instance, for the Manhattan Great, the star. I carve out the shape on a block. And I also make my own papers, as you see here.
Just like the sculptures, these prints have great texture. You're all about texture.
That's right. I love the texture, and I love handmade papers because they're thick, and the pressure of the press makes a great deep embossment in them.
And you said you could briefly run us through how you make these, just kind of a little insight to help those aspiring artists if they want to get started.
Well, I only have a small screen here, but a deposit of paper pulp dries on the screen afterwards, and you'll get these different textured papers that I work in layers on the prints. And a shiny print actually will have a shiny color of the shape that's the round shape for the little star grate.
So you make a tracing,
right.
You transfer it onto like a linoleum print you were showing me.
Right, and then on the block I would put the gold paper down. After this block is inked with a black ink, I would put the gold paper down, put some glue, and put the next size paper down that has some texture on it. Some more ink is put in here that would go on it.
So each piece is an original.
Right. They're really more like monoprints. And then when they're lifted up, it depends what color I printed. There's one in the other room like that. There's one of these like this.
Well, Bobby Mastrangelo has been creating manhole art since 1979, but now she's taking it to the streets. So if you see a green manhole cover in Port Jefferson, there's a good reason why. So what's this all about?
Well, we decided that just before my show at Prism Art Gallery, we were trying to promote the Soma Art District, which is south on Main Arts in Port Jeff, and that if we painted the water covers and manhole covers all the way from the harbor up to Jones Street, encompassing all the galleries and the places, that people would start paying attention and follow them. So different merchants sponsored the covers, like this one. The Port Jeff Sewer cover was painted green, and a group of us wore t-shirts, the middle grade students and their teachers.
The students helped you do all the painting.
Yes, yes. So we had a regular happening during the Maritime Festival on, I think it was near September 12th.
So this not only celebrates art within the Port Jefferson area, it celebrates your gallery exhibit just up the street.
The Prism Gallery opening, and it makes people pay attention, care about their streets. It beautifies it a little bit.
And just by chance, we have some work crews over here. Is this like your dream to see
the work crews with your
manhole covers?
If ever I have a camera around, I take pictures because they really are working. They work in the beginning product, and I'm the byproduct. At the end, I do artwork based on their utility work.
So these guys may not know it, but they're your inspiration.
That's right. That's right. They really keep things going.